I want you to know that I've had a laboratory. For 18 years, I've conducted the Beth Tikva Synagogue Choir. And for 18 years, I've had my liturgical music coming back at me. Music that I've composed and that people have sung and prayed to. Very often, it has formed the basis for Sweet Hebraics, liturgical music that I've composed for the synagogue.
Do you separate the music that we've just heard, the choral music, the overtly religious music, from so-called secular music, or is it all one to you?
No, it's all one. All my music is an attempt to be spiritual in one way or another. The flute sonata is a perfect example because at the end of it, I use a Rosh Hashanah prayer. There's a melody that goes, Adonai Melech, Adonai Malach, Adonai Imloch Leolam Vaed, which essentially means God lives, lived, and will live forever. And I introduce this at the end of the flute sonata because the flute sonata is kind of this wonderful praise of life. And how can I praise life without praising God?
I first met Srul Irving Glick in the old CBC radio building on Jarvis Street in downtown Toronto. He was a compact man, and with his beard and his kippah, more than a bit rabbinical. It was the mid-80s, and I was a fresh CBC hire, new to Toronto, not knowing a soul. Srul and his wife Dorothy invited me to share a Passover Seder with their family. Their hospitality was a godsend. I was familiar with Srul's reputation, but the man I came to know wasn't the Srul of legend, the producer of innumerable award-winning records, concert series, and radio documentaries. Now he looked hunted. He'd been demoted, assigned a rough cubicle, and delegated menial tasks. Without any humor, he told me, "They're out to get me." Srul's brother Norman.
It was a nasty piece of business, I think, at the time. And they just wanted him out of there. You know, I mean, that was obvious. I mean, you know, time has come. Either you walk out or we'll push you down the elevator shaft. Okay? So, we certainly encouraged them to get proper legal advice and proper direction and he negotiated if you have to go you got to go and he made the best deal he could and that was it. I think he took a serious emotional hit with that firing.
Glick left the CBC in 1986. Life changed dramatically as the family recalibrated to a composer's income. A couple of years later, Glick's friend Frank Rasky interviewed him for the Anthology of Canadian Music.